At Rainbow Day Camp, kids sing silly songs, play ball, make art, and do wacky relay races. But what makes this summer program unique is the campers it serves, transgender children, some as young as 4 years old. It's a place where they can use the pronoun of their choice and meet other transgender kids and adults, including many of the camp counselors.
They're following their creative interests, and they don't have this added stress or weight of being othered. They get to be their most authentic selves and build community with other people who understand the same life experience.
People aren't like, oh, they're more like, okay, that's cool, and then we just move on.
Transgender fluid person.
Sandra Collins, a former college professor, started the program 2 years ago after she struggled to find a camp where her transgender daughter Scarlett would feel comfortable.
You know, I used to say that the camp began out of sadness because of this experience, but a friend encouraged me to reframe it, that the camp began out of love, out of trying to create a safe space for my daughter and then other kids who were like her.
Enrollment has since tripled to 60 campers from California and beyond.
I like to be who I am, and it's not fun to be who I am not.
Experts say the camp's growth mirrors the sharp increase in transgender children across the country.
We are definitely seeing more kids, many more kids, socially transitioning at very young ages. And the reason we're seeing them more is because we're looking for them and letting them be found.
For critics who question whether preschool-age kids should be allowed to transition so early, developmental psychologist Diane Aronsef says children can identify their gender at a very young age.
We expect a two-year-old to know, I am boy, I am girl. So why can't that also apply to transgender children?
Banana flag.
Molly Maxwell says that's what happened when her child was a toddler.
Once she learned to talk and have a voice, she was very insistent that she was not a boy, she was a girl, and to call her a girl.
James Kaplan's mom doesn't regret allowing her child to transition.
I had to mourn the loss of my daughter and at the same time welcome my son and get to know him. And as soon as he transitioned, he was happier, he was confident.
And building confidence and community is what Rainbow Day Camp is all about. Terry Che, Associated Press, El Cerrito, California.